That's LeGarrette Blount here, man, three-time Super Bowl champion. I just want to give you a shout-out to the YouTube channel, Micro Mike, man.
Eddie Murray, former Detroit Lion. Make sure you watch Micro Mike on YouTube.
Calvin Johnson Jr. here, a.k.a. Megatron. Big shout-out to Micro Mike and YouTube channel, man.
Keep on talking everything Detroit Lions, and I just got to remind you, man, happy wife, happy life.
What's going on YouTube? This is your boy Mr. Micro Mike, and today we're going to talk about best available free agents, targets for Detroit Lions, and whose individuals we can look at regarding adding additions to our team. With that said, make sure you subscribe to my channel, hit the bell for all of my notifications, leave me a comment and tell me what you think about some of the free agents and who do you want. Also, check this out. Subscribe to the members of ISN. Why did I pick a lot of defensive linemen, a defensive edge rusher, defensive tackle? The reason I just feel that this is the position that we need to really focus on and make sure that it's not a weakness of the team last year. Last year, that position was the reason I feel that we lost a lot of games. We were not getting after the quarterback, we're not stopping the run. It is extremely, extremely vital that we stop the run and get after the quarterback. That's how you win football games. I think right now that may be the weakest position we have on the team. Let's go through the positions. Quarterback, we're good unless Stafford gets hurt. We're screwed anyways, okay? Wide receiver core, we're solid. We don't need to pick up another one. Tight ends, we're solid. We don't need to pick up another one. We could get an offensive lineman, but I think only possibly Larry Warford would be an only individual that they could look at when it comes to a free agent. But I don't think they're going to go there. I think they're fairly happy with the offensive line. I would like to maybe get a Joe Tooney, but that seems extremely unlikely. That's just my personal thing. But we're fairly solid there on the offensive line. It's not like it's a negative for the team. We look at the secondary. The secondary is solid, safety and cornerback position. Linebacking core, we could get an upgrade there. You know, I obviously I'm not a fan of Christian Jones. You all know that. But I feel like the defensive line, that is the position of weakness. Yes, we drafted Akwara. Yes, we got players back due to the health injury of last year. But in regards to what happened last year with the injuries, with the lack of depth due to those injuries, it was a massive destroyer of our team. The reason we ranked 31 had a lot to do with that defensive line. We need to get pressure on the interior and the quarterback. We need to stop the run. We need to have fresh bodies when it's the fourth quarter. We need to make sure that this does not happen again, what happened to us last year. We cannot afford that. If we suck and we're not getting after the quarterback because of the defensive line, guess what? It doesn't matter how solid the secondary is. They're going to get beat up. It doesn't matter how solid the linebacking core, we're going to get beat up. We will lose many football games again. You can't keep the foot on the pedal if you cannot stop the run. You can't keep the foot on the pedal if you cannot get after the quarterback. You cannot keep the foot on the pedal if the quarterback is sitting in the pocket for 7-8 seconds. I am happy that we got players back, but I'm extremely worried that the team will get injured again. The team will get tired again, and results happened from last year will occur this year. I want to make a weakness a strength. Last year, our weakness was tight end. We made it a strength. That was awesome. Also, our secondary was a weakness before free agency and everything. They did make it a strength. And they jumped back on it this year when it comes to getting Harmon, when it comes to getting Trufant, when it comes to drafting Okuda. I want to make this defensive line a strength, and that's why I focus a lot on these players. So here you go. Check them out. Honorable mentions would be Vinny Curry, Clay Matthews, Michael Bennett, and Jabal Sheard. But let's get into the big guys. So we're just going to go over a couple free agent targets that I think the Lions could look at, not necessarily individuals that want to get, but you're going to notice a trend here. It's basically all defense. So we're going to go ahead and start with defensive lineman Timmy Jernigan from the Philadelphia Eagles. He's 27 years old. He would be an extremely light contract if they're wanting to go that route. He definitely wouldn't be anything upgrade. He would be a depth player, but they could go that route if they're just trying to have more individuals on the depth chart on the lower end of the spectrum. Personally, I wouldn't go get him, but that is definitely an individual they can look at. He's only had 2 sacks, 3 tackles for loss, and a quarterback hit. He only started in 9 games, so that would be a cheap end individual. They can also look at Marcus Golden, formerly of the New York Giants. He's only 29 with 72 tackles, 10 sacks, and 1 fumble recovery. So nothing major when it comes to Marcus Golden. He, again, would be a cheap salary of probably around, I don't know, not that much. But he would be an individual they could look at as well. Again, upon as an edge rusher, you can throw him inside of Trey Flowers. That's another individual they could look at. He's not too old. He started all 16 games, and he predominantly would work well in a 3-4 defensive scheme, just like we do with the Detroit Lions. They can also take a look at Epherson Griffin. Obviously, the edge rusher, he's 32. His stats are 8 sacks, 11 tackles. This guy was formerly of the Minnesota Vikings. He's obviously a fan favorite right now when it comes to Detroit. Obviously, the Gridiron Blitz, part of ISN. He has been rooting for this guy to join the team. Matt Patricia wants him, and Epherson Griffin says LFG. So he would be an individual they could target, throw again on the opposite side of Trey Flowers, and really help upon getting after the quarterback for the Detroit Lions. They can look at defensive end Jadeveon Clowney. He's formerly of the Seattle Seahawks. He's 27 years old. His stats are 3 sacks, 4 fumbles, and he would be an individual they could throw in the defensive line, but he's going to be looking at a high-end contract. The spectrum for him would be a lot, and he has injury history. So they could go that route. Personally, I don't think they do, simply because of the money that he's going to demand. I don't even think he wants to be a Lion. He wants to get paid, and it's not going to be here in Detroit. Marcell Dareus, the defensive lineman, that's an individual I always be paying attention to, because I just feel we need depth at the defensive line. He had a little bit of injury history, but he would be a cheap contract. I think the Lions could utilize him and adding him to the depth of the defensive line. He's only 30 years old, and again, he would be a rotational player. With that said, folks, tell me who you want. Who do you covet? Who do you think the Lions could sign? We'll see. They could make a trade or something at some point. I'm not 100% sure. Right now, it's a little quiet, but that's kind of the individuals I'd like to take a look at, and we'll go from there. Adios.